Ciao mondo, hello world, hola mundo, hello mond, konnichiwa, ni hao, namaste. We are pleased today to share a cappuccino with Ilona Bobek, one of my former fellows at the International Renal Research Institute of Vicenza, and now part of the Department of Anesthesiology and Intensive Care Therapy at the Central Hospital of Southern Pest National Institute of Hematology and Infectious Disease in Budapest. So thank you very much, Ilona, for joining. And we are now very much interested in the new sorbent therapies. And I know you have a wide experience on the HA380 cartridge manufactured by Jafron. And I would like to ask you, what are the criteria for you to start the therapy with this hemoadsorption and subsequently how you do it, specifically with I would like focus on the possible use of citrate anticoagulation.
Thank you very much, Prof. And I'm very honored and happy to talk with you about it. I have to tell you that, yes, in Hungary and in our center, we have some experiences. As you mentioned, the name of our hospital and the specialty, as we have a big hematological intensive care, infectious diseases, we are one of the biggest COVID-19 center in our country, and also we take care of burn patients. So therefore, in our center, except the cardiac surgical indications, we use for many, many indications in different type of group of patients who are in mostly a hyperinflammatory state. We used successfully the H1-380 cartridge for case of necrotizing pancreatitis. As you know, it has a very good spectrum. The range of the absorbed molecules are between 10 and 60,000 Dalton. And it's including the inflammatory mediators we want to move away, like the cytokines, like interleukin 6 or 8 or TNF-alpha. We like it because it's very easy to connect to any type of extracorporeal machine. We used to use it mostly with CRRT, but it's applicable with ECMO or the cardiopulmonary bypass. And I know some centers where they use in standalone mode. We don't use standalone. We always integrate in a CRRT. And I have to tell you that in our hospital, I can say mostly because of the burn unit, that cytokine adsorption techniques, it's a routine treatment for us. And when you ask about our policy, that regarding our experience, we try to apply it as early as possible in the early phase of the diseases. And before the citrate era, we used it with unfractioned heparin based on the APT level, or I have to tell you, for hematological patients, we use nothing for anticoagulation. And also, we could manage the cytokine adsorption, even though these circuits were more frequent thromboses we recognize. But nowadays, almost 100% of our cases are with regional citrate anticoagulation. And the advantage of it, I have to tell you that almost every groups of our patients are benefit. They have the benefit of it. It's very easy to use for our very special hematological patients who are thrombocytopenic in aplasia, and we have no problems with citrate anticoagulation. So we don't see any bleeding complication which can regard or the cytokine absorption, the technique itself with this patient. And I have to tell you, because we use different CRRT machines, and it depends very much on the type we use, because we can place the cartridge in a pre and a post dialyzer, dialysis filter mode. If we have the chance, we prefer the pre-filter mode. The key point of the treatment, that if we use it post-filter, that whichever is the second filter, if it's the cartridge or the dialysis filter, that the post-filter ionized calcium, we have to keep in the range of 0.25 in our unit and 0.4. This is our practice. But I have to tell you that for the COVID-19 patients, we keep the lowest safe level. It's usually 0.25. And the calcium replacement, it's certainly based on systemic ionized calcium level. And just avoiding the cytate accumulation, we each day measure the total blood calcium level. So this is our practice in Hungary, in Budapest.
Ilona, what blood flow did you use?
It depends on the mode we use, the CRRT mode. I have to tell you that it can be 150 if we use, for example, PrismaFlex. But if we use the Omni or we use the multifiltrate by Fresenius, then we go down for 120. These are the ranges.
And you never saw complications related to acid base?
Sometimes, yes, but very rare, I have to tell you.
Okay.
And also, we can compensate it.
And also, was the platelet count stable during treatment?
Not always. To be honest, not always. We recognized in some cases that we had a thrombocytopenia, which we think it's depended on the treatment. But that was reversible, and that was good. But that's why we are very cautious with our hematological patients, because their average platelet level, it's around 10,000 and 20,000.
So just to close this cappuccino, what do you find? Why do you find this H380 cartridge from Jafrom unique? What are the unique characteristics in your view?
As I mentioned, the molecular range we can remove. And I have to tell you that the safety, we based on this, and I base my opinion on your study, which had been done in 2018, your in vitro study. And we found in vivo that it's safe.
Very good. So from one side, safety, from the other, efficiency and efficacy in reducing the level of those molecules that are considered dangerous in patients with sepsis and septic shock. And now in COVID-19, of course.
Yeah, we do okay. A lot.
So Ilona, thank you very much for joining today, Cappuccino. It is a pleasure to have a cappuccino with you, and let's go back to the official scientific program.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Excellent.
It is.